Hello, my name is Zach, and in this video, we're going to be looking at the basics of SuiteScript. Hopefully by the end of this, you'll have a fundamental understanding of what SuiteScript is and how it fits into the NetSuite ecosystem, as well as looking at a demo of how it can be used to make NetSuite do something it hasn't or doesn't natively do. First off, SuiteScript itself sits on top of NetSuite. In previous videos in this channel, we've talked about what NetSuite actually is and SuiteScript as a whole. But to summarize, NetSuite is an accounting software on top of a database, and SuiteScript is a way to interact with that database. SuiteScript itself is built on top of JavaScript and uses custom modules, which can be thought of as libraries that are made by NetSuite and then can be leveraged inside of SuiteScript to create custom interfaces, manipulate data, aggregate data, and overall automate business practices to make people's lives easier. No longer do they have to work with certain like Excel calculators to go through complex formulas, and is something that NetSuite does a great job natively supporting. SuiteScript itself has a couple different versions. A lot of older or legacy code is written in SuiteScript 1.0, but now there is SuiteScript 2.x, 2.0, and 2.1, with SuiteScript 2.1 being the most recommended and fits the most business cases as it contains the most modern JavaScript. From there, SuiteScript can be used to automate people's manual tasks and turn it into an automation that they can reference when they need to, on demand. It's a way to extend the software beyond what it normally does and provide functionality that otherwise doesn't exist inside of NetSuite. SuiteScript itself has over 10 different script types at this point, and the five most commonly used have already been talked about on this channel, and you're able to find that link in the description. But to summarize, we first off start with the user event script, which is used to automate record saving, loading, and what to do after you have a record. The client script, which can be used to update stuff inside of a person's browser and change the way it looks or make sure that there's some kind of validation, so incorrect information isn't entered. Then there's a suitelet where you can create custom interfaces, do custom reporting, and generally just make a page that doesn't already exist inside of NetSuite. Next, we have a MapReduce, which can be used to update a large amount of records and typically executes on a list of records, which could be from a saved search, a query, or even a static list, and for each value does something. And lastly, we have the RESTlet, where it is the main script type for integrations, and all the other script types are for more niche cases, like when you install a bundle, you want to do custom accounting, or for capturing email requests. So let's actually take a look at that and get into the demo. So in front of you, we have a sales order, and what I want to do is I want to look at a NetSuite record in a slightly different format than what you're commonly used to seeing. As we have this, you see we have the nice pretty UI that's all styled and looks good. But let's go ahead and go to the URL bar at the top, and we're going to type in an ampersand XML equals capital T. And what this is going to do is give us a new view of the data on this record. So at the top, you can see we have a record tag, as well as other information like sales order. We get to see an internal ID, but let's actually take a look at the stuff down below. So as I'm scrolling through here, you'll start to see some stuff that might look familiar, as if we look back at that original sales order, we have a order number of 2401. Look for 2401, or use Control F, for example, you'll see that it's in a couple of different places. Now, on the left, the opening tag has tran ID, which should be familiar if you've ever looked at field IDs. If not, I'll show you how to do that. If we go back to the sales order and click on order number, we get a help text pop-up, and on that says field ID with a colon tran ID, which is the exact same value that we saw over in the XML. Okay, so now that we've looked and found the document number, let's go ahead and look for another field. For example, let's go back to the sales order and try to find the customer. So clicking on the customer label, you'll see that we get the same help text, except this time the field ID is different. In this case, it says entity. So going back to the XML and scrolling up to the E's, you'll see that we have entity, but the value is 1834, which is different than what we saw in the UI or user interface. Why is that? So we have a concept of text and value inside of NetSuite records. The text is the label that the users will see and can make sense of, or contains a more human readable format, whereas the value is the internal ID of the record. So in the case of customers, you can see that IC-US West is the text or the label of the customer, where the internal ID is what we found in the XML, which is 1834. The difference between the XML and what we saw in the user interface is that NetSuite has a text and a value property, and the text value is the human readable portion, whereas the value is the internal ID of the attached record. So in this case, IC US West is the label, is the text, whereas 1834 is the value. So what this hopefully gives you is a view that NetSuite records are just data, and we're able to aggregate or change them and view them in different ways than NetSuite natively supports. So from here, let's actually try to make some SuiteScript. So we're going to go to Documents, Files, SuiteScripts. And on here, we have a folder already prepared named SuiteScript Basics. And inside of there, we have a user event script template that I've already pre-made for this demonstration. So to actually update it, let's go ahead and click Edit. Okay, so here we have the file opened up in NetSuite, and you'll see down at the media item, we have an edit button. And what this will do will let us open up the file in our browser, and we can edit the text right here. Instead of using something like an IDE or an integrated development environment, for example, you could use VS Code or WebStorm to edit it locally and then upload the files or upload any changes to those files to the SuiteScript folder. So let's actually take a look at the file here and understand what is going on. So at the very top, we have a couple important comments in a multi-line comment. We have N API version 2.1, which specifies our SuiteScript version. Next, we have N module scope. And what that does is it specifies that our script will be working in the current account that we're doing development in. And next, we have N script type. And what this does is it actually specifies a script type that we have already talked about previously, in this case, a user event script. And then we get into the actual JavaScript code. So at the top, we have define, which is used to include custom NetSuite modules, which we will actually add here in a moment. And then we have a function which takes in parameters, and we can pass those custom modules in and use them like library files. Then we have three more functions in this template, which have the entry points of a user event script. In this case, before load, before submit, and after submit. And those are returned down at the bottom as functions. And then NetSuite handles the rest. From there, you are able to create a script type, and we'll again get to that in the future. So the demo that we're going to be covering today is adding a field to NetSuite that doesn't already exist, not using the interface, but using SuiteScript. And whatever value we put into it, I want to copy to the memo field when we save the record, in this case, the sales order. So let's go ahead and do that. At the top, we're going to include our first custom module. In this case, we're going to be adding the server widget module. So we're going to type n/UI/server widget. And then we're going to pass it in as a parameter to our function. Okay, now that we've loaded the server widget module, what we're able to do is actually update the forms that NetSuite provides us and do things like adding fields, hiding fields, making them mandatory, all with SuiteScript. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to create our new field. And to do that, we are going to have to check some documentation. And to do that, I'm going to go back to our browser. And at the top, I'm going to type in SuiteScript and then server widget documentation. And the first thing that pops up is the Oracle documentation for the n/UI/server widget module. The way that Oracle documentation pages work is we have a description at the top that gives you a brief overview of what the record, the method, or the enum actually does, and then provides examples or better represents what we have access to with that module. So down below, we have server widget module members, and you can see it has things here like server widget.button or server widget.form. And it's not important what all of these are right now. You're able to read this right column that says description and get a brief understanding of what it does. And always you can navigate to the page and get a better explanation there. So what we're trying to do is we're trying to add a field to the form. So let's actually scroll down and look for the form portion of this. since we know that that's what we want to add the field to. And you'll see we have form object members. So you'll see there's some interesting methods here, things like form.addButton, form.addField, or form.addFieldGroup. Again, reading on the right, we'll have the description. The one that we're looking for says adds a field to the form, and that is form.addField. It takes some options. Let's figure out what they are. So to do that, we're going to visit the page by clicking on the link. You'll see that we opened up a new page, and it goes straight to form.addFields. And you'll notice that as a parameter, it takes options. There's a note that's provided that says the options parameter is a JavaScript object. And then down below that, we have a table of parameters. So in this left column, you see what key we need to pass to the object, in this case, ID. You can see the type, it takes a string. You can see that it is required, meaning that if it is not included, NetSuite will throw an error. And you can see a description, which is a breakdown of what it is. In this case, it says it takes the internal ID of the field, and it specifies further that the internal ID must be lowercase, no spaces, and include the prefix cust page. So let's go ahead and actually try this out. So the first thing I'm going to do is go back to our file with our pop-up. You'll see that part of the context that's provided on before load is the form that we're currently looking at. So in terms of context, you can look at this later, but before load happens before the record actually enters the browser of the user or whoever's looking at it. So this is the perfect time to add a field as the page hasn't been rendered yet. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's make a new line. And on here, we're going to add form.add capital F field. And then again, it's specified as a help text that it takes a JavaScript object as a parameter and put in our JavaScript curly brackets. And then from here, we'll refer back to the documentation and see that we take an ID, a label, and a type. Those are all required. So let's go ahead and add those. I'm going to press enter to open it up, and we're going to do ID colon. And if you remember, this was the internal ID that we give the field, and it has to be prefixed by cust page. So cust page, memo, copy. And let's go ahead and add then the label. And I'm going to name it memo copy. And for the type, let's go back and check the documentation. As you know, I don't know this one off the top of my head, and it's good to refer every once in a while. You can see that the type parameter takes the server widget.fieldtype enum. So what enums are a list of curated values that NetSuite won't change, but the enums give us a comfortable way to refer to them. Server widget.fieldtype has the values of checkbox, currency, date time. These look very similar to the field options that we have when we look at creating a field in the NetSuite UI. The one that we want to talk about and use today is the text area field, as that is what the NetSuite memo uses. So let's go ahead and actually copy this and add this type to our script. So jumping back to our file, we go to type and do server widget dot and then capital F field, capital T type dot, and then we can paste in our text area type. And what this should do is create our custom field. So let's actually go ahead and take a look at that. So I'm going to go ahead and save this record. Okay, so now that we've created the script and we have the deployment, it should only run for the current user that made it, which is us in this case. So let's go back to that sales order and actually refresh and look for our field. So in the bottom right, you'll see that we have memo copy. And if we actually edit it, it will now show an editable text box, just like the memo up above. So now what we wanted to do is, like I said, I want to be able to type in here and then save and have it get copied over to the memo field. So now let's go ahead and add that to our script. So let's go back to the file and click on edit, and we'll get the pop-up window again since we've saved the record. And from here, we're going to go down to before submit. The before submit happens after the user clicks save and before it actually gets saved into the database. So this is the perfect time to update our value, as the new memo value will exist when it actually goes to save. So let's actually go ahead and do that. The first thing we want to do is get whatever value was in our custom field. So to do that, we can do new record dot get value. And the parameter that it takes is a field ID inside of an object. This is where we can put our custom field ID. And what this will do, will return a value. So we can declare a variable and name it that. So the next thing we would want to do is we want to actually take this value that we've gotten from a field and set it into another field. So to do that, we can type new record dot set value this time. And what it takes from four parameters is field ID. And this is where we want to set it. So in this case, we want to set it to memo. And memo's internal ID is memo. And we want to provide also the value of what we want to set it to. In this case, memo copy value. And now that that's done, we can go ahead and save our new file and then actually go back to our sales order and give it a test. So I'm still editing. And because a user event script is server side and not client side, we're able to actually just make our update here without having to refresh. So let's go ahead and type in a message here. And then let's save the record and see if it works. Okay, now that it is saved, you can see here in the memo field, we actually have hello SuperSuite. And just like that, our script has allowed NetSuite to do something that it natively doesn't already do. And you've seen how we can actually create a custom field and copy a value from a field to another field. And that's all I have for you. So if you like this video or you found it helpful and you want to see more on SuiteScript, then leave a comment down below. And with that, I'll see you in the next video.